Hello everybody, today again we are going to see some problems which are depend on the concept triangles. Okay, so first problem is, today's first problem is, in figure AB is equals to AC, BE and CF are respectively the bisector of angle B and angle C. Prove that triangle EBC congruent triangle FCB. Okay. So here see, once again I am reading this question and we will see figure also. AB is equals to AC, triangle in triangle ABC, AB and AC two sides are equal, means definitely this is an isosceles triangle. Okay, if sides are equal, angles opposite of equal sides are always equal. So here we can say angle B and angle C are equal. Okay, we can understand this from first statement. AB is equals to AC, BE and CF are respectively the bisectors of angle B and C. BE and CF are the bisectors. Okay, BE and CF are the bisectors of angle B and C. Means what? Bisector means EBC and FBE are equal. These two angles are equal, and here these two angles are equal. Okay, because that BE and CF are the bisectors. Okay. Then what is given? Prove that triangle EBC congruent triangle ECB. EBC congruent FCB. Okay. These two triangles we have to prove congruent. Understood. So now, if you'll observe here, just now I told you AB and AC are equal, that means this is an isosceles triangle. Okay. So here first we will write in solution triangle. In triangle ABC, AB is equals to AC. AB is equals to AC. So we can say here angle ABC is equals to angle ACB. ABC is equals to ACB because angles opposite of equal sides. Okay, angles which are opposite of equal sides. Equal sides are same. Okay. So here ABC, angle ABC is equals to angle ACB. Understood. So here ABC, angle ABC, we can write ABC, we can write FBC, because we are thinking about these two triangles, FBC and ECB. Because that only we have to prove, those triangles we have to prove congruent. So instead of ABC, we can write FBC. Okay, so that I am taking here angle FBC is equals to angle, instead of ACB, we can write ECB. Okay, is equals to angle ECB. Okay, so this is first one. Okay, so now we have one angle, that is this angle, and this angle is equal. Okay, that one thing we have now. Now one more thing we have about these two triangles, that is BC is common for both the triangles. So that one thing, one side we can use, but we need one more angle. Okay, so what we can do, again we can use the same thing. So again I'm taking here again angle ABC is equals to angle ACB. Okay, with the same reason, angles opposite of equal sides. Okay, if you will take half of both the sides, that is half of LHS and half of RHS, half of angle ABC is equals to half of angle ACB. Okay, if you will take half of both the sides, then what we will get? See, half of ABC we can write ECB, or half of ABC is this angle half. We can write here EBC. Okay, and here FCB. Okay, so here I am taking EBC, half of angle ABC is equals to half angle EBC is equals to FCB, angle FCB. Okay, means we are thinking about this. This and this is equal. Okay, because that is half of, this is half of angle B and that is half of angle C. Okay, so this we will say this is second one. And third thing we have, that is BC is equals to BC. That is common side for both the triangles. So we can use directly. So now I am taking here. Now we will take here triangles. In triangle EBC and triangle FCB. Okay. First thing is angle ABC. FBC is equals to angle ECB. Okay. Reason from 1. Here we have given 1. So here we can write from 1. That is enough. Okay. So FBC is equals to ECB. Then second thing, BC is equals to BC. BC is common side. So BC is equals to BC. So this is common. And third thing is, just now this is angle EBC. Angle EBC is equal to angle FCB. EBC. EBC is this angle and this angle. Okay. Are equal. FCB from that angle C and EBC from that angle B. This angle. Okay. So now we can say with the help of this is from second one. So with the help of these three things, angle, side, angle, we can say triangle EBC congruent triangle FCB by ASA, angle, side, angle. Okay. And that was our question. Triangle EBC congruent triangle FCB. Okay. So by ASA criteria, we can give this proof. Understood, everybody? See once again, what was given? Triangle ABC was given. They have told us AB is equals to AC, means AB, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. So we can take base angles are equal, angle ABC equal to angle ACB. Angle ABC we can write FBC, because here angle is important. So we have taken this name because we are thinking about these two triangles. Then again we have taken the same thing, angle ABC here we have taken. Now take the half of both the sides. When you will take half of both the sides, that time EBC and FCB, these two triangles angles you will get. And now this is our second thing. So from first, second and third, BC is common for both the sides, both the triangles. So from 1, 2 and 3, we can say both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so see here our next problem is, if triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB is equal to AC, prove that the perpendicular from the vertices B and C to their opposite sides are equal. Okay, figure is given. Once again see, if triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle, prove that the perpendicular from the vertices B and C, perpendicular from the vertices B and C, this is perpendicular, this is also perpendicular, perpendicular drawn through the, prove that the perpendicular from the vertices B and C to their opposite side. Okay, this is AB is the opposite for angle C and AC is opposite for angle B. Okay, are equal, means here we have to prove EC and BD are equal. Okay, to prove, what we have to prove? To prove EC is equals to DB. Okay, this we have to prove. So according to this, we need to think about the solution. Okay, so now see here carefully, if I want to show this EC and DB are equal, if this triangle EC is the side of triangle ECB and BD is the side of triangle DCB. If both triangle means EBC and DCB, if we are able to prove both the triangles are congruent, then by CPCT we can say EC and DB are equal. Okay, so now we have to prove these two triangles are equal. Understood? So as they have told us, AB and AC are equal. AB and AC are equal. So we can write here in triangle ABC, AB is equals to AC. This is given. It is given in the question. AB and AC are equal. So we can say angle ABC is equals to angle ACB. okay, because angles, opposite of equal sides, opposite of equal sides are always same. Okay, so angle ABC is equals to angle ACB. So this angle and this angle is equal. Now one angle we have, okay, we got one angle, this angle we have, okay. Now after this, what we can do? One more angle is, they have told us this angle is perpendicular, okay. So we can say ECEB is equals to BDC, okay. Angle CEB is equals to CEB is equals to BDC, angle BDC, BDC, both 90 degree, because they have told us, prove that the perpendicular from the vertices B and C, okay, BD and EC are perpendiculars, means definitely base angles of this perpendiculars is 90 degree. So both are 90 means that one angle we have, one angle we got is this, and this is second angle, okay. One more thing which is common, BC, BC is the common side for both the triangles, okay. So we can take BC is equals to BC, which is common side for both the triangles, okay, common side. Now two angles we have and side we have, two angles and side, but this side is not included by these two angles. So here we cannot say ASA, but we can say AAS by angle, angle, side, okay. By AAS, these two triangles are congruent, understood, because this side is not included by these two angles, okay. This is different side, but of the same triangle, understood. So here we can say triangle, here we can say EBC, triangle EBC, congruent triangle EBC, DCB, triangle DCB by AAS, by AAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, then we can say EC and DB are equal, EC and DB, EC is equals to DB, why? By CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle, okay, by CPCT both the triangles are congruent. Got it everybody? Very simple proof. When such type of sides are coming, that time we need to prove most of the times triangles congruent. If triangles are congruent, then corresponding parts are also congruent, okay. Okay, so see here, next problem is, if altitude from the two vertices of a triangle to the opposite sides are equal, prove that the triangle is isosceles, okay. So see here carefully, triangle ABC is given and we have to prove that that triangle is isosceles. But what is given? See, if altitude from the two vertices of a triangle to the opposite sides are equal, altitudes are equal, they have told us CF and BE, these are the altitudes, okay. CF from C point, angle C, and BF, BE from angle B, both the altitudes are equal. So first we will take given things. In given, what we can write? In triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, triangle ABC, what we can write? CF, CF is equals to BE, is equals to BE. This is given, altitudes are equal. Altitude means what? Perpendicular to the base, perpendicular height, okay. It is height, so perpendicular to the base. So this angle means, we can say CFA and AEB are, angles are same, 90 degree, okay. So that also we are going to use. So now what we have to prove? Prove that the triangle is isosceles, means here we have to prove triangle ABC, to prove triangle ABC is an isosceles, isosceles triangle. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. We have to prove. Isosceles triangle means what we need to prove? AB and AC are equal. In short, what we are going to show? AB and AC are equal. This is our target. According to this, we have to think. Understood? AB and AC are equal. Suppose I am going to use here two triangles from triangle ABC. If I am going to use two triangles to show both the triangles are congruent, then one I need to think about these two sides. Okay, AB, I need to choose such type of triangles whose one side is AB and AC. Okay, so here which triangle I will take? ABE, and second I will use ACF. Okay, because in that ABE, which side is coming? AB, and ACF, which side is given? AC. That only both the sides we need to show congruent. Okay, so accordingly we will take here in proof, in triangle ABE, triangle ABE and triangle ABE and triangle ACF, triangle ACF, ACF, which things we have now? First thing we have, that is ABE, okay, ABE and triangle ACF, which angle we have? This angle, angle E and angle F are equal. So we can write angle in ABE, ABE, we can write angle AEB is equals to angle AEB is equals to angle AFC, AFC. Okay, both angles are 90 degree, both 90 degree. Okay, next we have, we are thinking about ABE, so we can write BAE, angle, angle BAE is equals to, BAE is equals to CAF, angle, angle CAF. Why both are same? Because that is common angle, that is common angle. Okay, so now two angles we have, two angles we have. So now what we can say? Which side we can use? What which we can use? FC is equals to EB. FC is equals to, FC is equals to EB. Both are equal. They have told us two vertices, altitude from the two vertices of a triangle to the opposite sides are equal. Okay, FC and EB are equal. So this is, we can say this is given thing. Okay, so now we can write with the help of these three things, which angle, angle and side, angle, angle and side. So by AAS, so triangle ABE congruent triangle ACF by AAS, angles, angle, side. Okay, both the triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, we can say AB is equals to AC, AB is equals to AC, because AB and AC are the sides of corresponding triangles and that are congruent. So CP, CT, corresponding part of congruent triangle, AB is equals to AC. Got it everybody? Only here one thing is important, that we need to choose such type of triangles whose sides according to the given target. We need to think about these triangles. Okay, thank you.